certainly want to say good morning to all of you all, the city of Danville, this morning on this brisk, beautiful fall November morning. We appreciate you all being here. It's truly a pleasure to be here today as we inaugurate this brand new new city dance space today. This space is for anyone who is curious about dance and who would like the opportunity to experience different cultures through dance, whether it be swing, jazz, shag, waltz, ballet, Zumba, or even belly dancing. I hope you brought your shoes today. I'm watching a couple of my council members. Their reputation precedes them. So a couple of people I want to thank. First of all, I want to publicly thank Rick Drzenowicz and Public Works, City of Danville Public Works. They did a wonderful job keeping things nice and tidy out here for us this morning. So I want to publicly thank him. Before I get too far down the list, there are some folks that I would like to recognize, our elected officials that we have in the House today. Mayor Sherman Saunders, Councilman Alonzo Jones, Councilman James Buckner, Councilman Lee Vogler. Did I happen to miss any councilmen in the place today? I want to make sure that I recognize each of you. Also, a few city staff members that we would like to recognize this morning. City Manager Joe King is here. Deputy City Manager Ken Larkin, and also want to recognize Kate Farmer with Danville, Pennsylvania Chamber of Commerce. At this time, we're going to have comments from our Honorable Mayor of the City of Danville, and so if you all would recognize him, put your hands together for the Honorable Sherman Saunders.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Tally. Good morning. And welcome to a celebration of yet another business opening in an area that is well known as Neapolis, or the New City. On the second floor of 616 North Main Street, Dania and Jose Uniga are opening the New City Dance Space. This new dance studio will offer a variety of dance classes to the community, including private and group ballroom dancing, social partnership dancing, belly dancing, adult bar, and Zumba. Classes will be offered for the beginner, intermediate, and advanced level dancers. Dania and Jose, thank you for choosing to locate your new studio in this district. We wish you many, many years of success. The city would like to also thank Steve DelGiorno for his investment in this district. Less than a year ago, the facade of 616 North Main Street was covered by a brick wall. Now, this building has been brought back to life with a new storefront and interior improvements. Steve, we thank you. And we hope you continue to invest in the city of Danville, and we appreciate the role you're playing in transforming North Main Street. Pablo Picasso once said, "Art washes away from the soul the dust of everyday life." To all who are involved in today's ceremony, thank you for aggressively helping us bring this district back to life through cultural amenities and the arts. Again, we thank you so very much.
I just realized and was notified by my good friend Linwood over here that I failed to introduce myself. My name is Telly Tucker. I'm the Director of Economic Development for the City of Danville. Very proud to be here representing the City of Danville. At this time, we're going to invite our business owners, Dania and Jose Zuniga, up front. I'm going to give you a little background information on them. They're going to come and share a little about their business. Jose began teaching ballroom dance in 1979 for Arthur Murray in Richmond, Virginia. He decided to become an independent ballroom professional in 1987 and relocated to Danville, Virginia, opening ZL's School of Social Dancing. He has been teaching in the Danville area ever since this time. Dania began teaching performing arts dancing in the 1989. Under the guidance of Vicki Rimmer at the Dance Arts Center here in Danville, Virginia. After graduating a valedictorian from Tunstall High School, Dania continued her education at Old Dominion University. She received a BA in speech communications with an emphasis on theater and dance in 1994. At this time, she returned to the area and bought Dance Arts Center from Miss Rimmer. Dania and Jose met in 1998 at a local festival where both were performing in their own styles. Then they collaborated on a piece that mixed their genres. After this, the rest is history. They began teaching together locally as well as regionally, in addition to competing in the ballroom and Latin styles. Together, they opened the Dance Space in 1999. This opened a new center where ballroom dancing and performing arts dance could be found in the same location. After some time, their focus migrated to strictly social dancing for couples, as well as advanced competitive dancing in the ballroom world. Dania and Jose are very excited to be continuing their dance journey in this lovely new studio. Please come out and visit their new home, New City Dance Space. They teach all level students as well as competing with their own students and each other. Dania and Jose enjoy sharing their love of dance with others. Please put your hands together for Dania and Jose Zuniga.
Thank you very much, folks. Today is it's a little overwhelming. So if I kind of stumble and stutter up here, please excuse me. We'll try to make up for it later when we do a little dance show. As a matter of fact, just this morning we found out that we were supposed to talk. Somebody was supposed to tell us last week, and I think that they don't want to see that look on her face. So they asked her, and she said, oh no, my husband will do this. She does have a very important job, though, because once I get going, I tend to ramble. So if you look at her, she'll be doing this. So, but once again, I guess the first thing I need to do is I need to put some thank yous out there. And I know you're probably getting tired of thank yous, but I have to say this. I want to thank Jerry Metters. He's the one that made this happen for us. He grabbed us by the scruff of the neck. And he's been actually showing us this property for several years. And it's become so gorgeous, we couldn't pass it up. I want to thank the city of Danville for all this fabulous opportunity this morning. So, and also, there's a lot of important here, a lot of important people here. A lot of you have very busy schedules, and I want to thank you for coming out. And as a matter of fact, there's a lot of closet dancers here, because I know a lot of you have taken lessons from me over the years. So, we've been in town many years teaching. We've been on West Main, we've been in Piney Forest, and we're very excited about this. This is an absolutely gorgeous facility. Steve, your vision is fabulous, and you really pulled it off. Thank you so much. And to be quite frank, even though, you know, my concern has always been, you know, trying to make a dance business go. And if you've seen all the movies, being a dancer can be a little bit tough sometimes. But right now, I'm actually very excited about being part of something a little bigger and seeing something special develop here. So I think I'm done. So folks, thank you all so much. Thank you so much for coming today. And thank you, everybody. We have pastries and we have a little dance show for you upstairs.
Actually, we don't. The city does. Sorry.
One more person that's an integral part of this redevelopment project, if you will, I would like to recognize. That is Steve Del Giorno. Steve is, make sure I get my notes here, Steve, getting you right. Steve has 25 years of marketing, branding, retailing, and food service experience. He spent 12 years living abroad in China, Korea, Hong Kong, Japan, and currently residing in Nashville. He is a 1981 graduate of George Washington High School. So whenever there's an opportunity for one of our own to come back, and we certainly appreciate that. If you would, Steve, at this time, welcome Steve, and maybe he'll have a few comments about the vision for this project and the redevelopment of North Main.
Thank you, Telly. In fact, I heard you're the first one to sign up for belly dancing lessons. And they're selling tickets just to watch that happen. But thank you very much. Mayor Saunders, members of City Council here today, residents of Neapolis, distinguished guests, I say thank you and good morning. About 4 years ago, my wife Angela and I, we decided it was time to invest some of our resources in real estate. And because of my job, I had the privilege of being able to travel all over the world. And we thought about investing maybe a villa in Italy or a little bungalow on the beaches of Thailand. And we also realized maybe it would be smarter, maybe less sexy, but we would come to the United States, which proved to be a much wiser decision. And I brought my wife to the United States to visit, and we looked at properties across Washington State. We looked in Chicago, New York, and we ended up back in Danville. And I first came to Danville in 1978. My father opened up the first Golden Corral restaurant on Piney Forest Road, in fact, across from where Dunn used to be. And I used to be the young guy there. I was a little younger back in 78, but I was doing magic tricks and making balloon animals at the table, all for a dollar. But I attended George Washington High School, and I worked at the radio station WBTM. And it was during that time I met my dearest friend in the world, even today, Linwood Duncan. And it was Linwood, actually, his vision more than 20 years ago that this area really was special and deserved to have kind of a rebirth, if you will. And over the years, staying in touch with Linwood, I was really impressed with what was going on in Danville. And as an outsider, I'd only lived here for 3 or 4 years, I was kind of had written Danville off, you know, with the mill and all of the constant bad news. But when I learned from Linwood constantly, the Institute coming with a new rebirth of economy for the 21st century, and the city's investment in its neighborhoods and in the inner city and downtown, my wife and I decided we wanted to be a part of that. So I brought her to Danville, and I saw Danville for the first time through the eyes of somebody who had never been here before, but who had seen the world. And my wife says, wow, this is like the Piedmont area of Italy. And she did not even, it's her words exactly. And she did not even know this was considered the Piedmont. And we were immediately drawn to Neapolis. And Neapolis, as Mayor Saunders said, translated into English means the new city. Can anything be more telling than what we're doing today to be in the new city here in Neapolis? Neapolis, if you didn't know, was actually a city on its own for 2 years. And it was given the name and established in 1894 when this building was constructed as Neapolis. And it was a city for 2 years until the city of Danville annexed it and made it part of Danville. So guys, don't worry, we have no succession plans. There's no conversations about that going on. But what you have here in Neapolis, we think, and we hope you'll agree, is quite special. You have this commercial district with the beautifully restored North Theater and now the new Thai restaurant. And now we have the new city dance space coming. You've got this economic, this commercial district that is untapped for potential right now, the way I see it. You have affordable housing all through this area, and that's attractive to us as well as we invest in neighborhoods. I don't know how many of you guys really realize this, but from the peaks, the bluffs here in Neapolis over on Front and Henry are the best views of Danville. Seriously. You can see you can see and enjoy the beauty of the river and the downtown just from up there, or if you stand on top of our building here. You have a welcoming population of residents here who are so happy to have new people come to town and to invest in their neighborhood. And equally important for me as an investor is there's opportunities in Neapolis. And for a small investor such as we are, the fact that we can come in and buy these beautiful homes at very affordable prices and restore them back to the life that we think they deserve and where they once were 75 to 100 years ago, it's very gratifying as an investor. And equally important is we're earning a respectable return on our investment. And that makes it even more worthwhile. So we purchased what was once called and referred to as the Redmond Building from the Danville Historical Society, thank you. And we've now rebranded this building as the 616. And as the mayor said, it was not pretty. It was an ugly building. But now we've restored it back to the beauty that it was in the 1930s. And it's been just a labor of love and a few frustrations along the way. And it's quite gratifying that to see all of you so interested to see it. And when you see it later today, we hope that you'll also be able to enjoy the beauty that we saw of these lofts. And you'll know why it's the perfect place for the new city dance place. So we're so happy that you guys share the same vision that we do to join our family. On a side note, my wife and I actually had envisioned the dance space coming here 4 years ago, but on the first floor. And we were going to live on the loft. When we came back to the United States, that was going to be our residence. She still asks me why. She loves it. It's just beautiful up there. You'll know when you see it. But it really deserves to be a dance place. And when you'll know it, you'll feel like you're in a dance studio in New York City or in London. And I know you guys got it. So I think we'll all have an opportunity to tour the facility here in just a few minutes as soon as I shut up. I do want to say thank you. Thank you for sharing your support. And we hope that you guys will spend more time in Neapolis. And also, I invite you to come and invest with us, because we think Neapolis is going to be an important part of Danville's future. Thank you very much.
Thank you again, Steve. We appreciate you sharing comments with us. At this time, we are going to move across the street for a ribbon cutting and a presentation, I believe, upstairs, as well as refreshments. Before we do that, there is one person that I would like to thank who truly has been a visionary for what's going on in the Central Business District and the River District. And she's the project manager in my office, Corey Teague. Would you guys give her a hand? She's a native Danvillian, and she works very hard, and is I'm very proud to have her as one of my team members. She's from North Danville too, Steve tells me.
Count of three. One, two, three.
Joining me now is Steve Del Giorno, who is the brains behind the transformation that's going on here on North Main Hill. He decided to come back to where he grew up and invest in this area, and we are so excited to have Steve with us. You heard a little bit about his story during the ceremony earlier today, but Steve, I just wanted to first thank you for making the investment back here Danville, and welcome back to the city.
Thank you very much. It's very gratifying to come back to Danville in this nature, for sure.
And I just love the story. Take me back. You said graduate of George Washington High School, 1981.
Yes, sir.
But father opened up the first Golden Corral here in the city, and you had a special job there when he opened that, right?
Yeah, and in 1978, my father came. We opened the Golden Corral on Pawnee Forest Road. And my main job was I would go from table to table and do magic tricks and make balloon animals. I was the in-house entertainment. Yeah.
Well, come a long way since then. Tell me a little bit about your background. Spent numerous years overseas, but then came back to the States recently.
Yeah, I spent the last 20 plus years in corporate world, working for a large branding and product development company, doing marketing and consulting.
Yeah.
And decided after living 12 years in Asia across Hong Kong and Tokyo and China and Korea, it was time to come home and come back to the United States.
Right.
And we decided Danville would be the ideal place to invest.
That's great. And as he mentioned, he could have invested anywhere in the world, but he chose Danville. And have your wonderful family here with you.
Sir.
And
yes,
I know your wife has enjoyed coming back to Danville as well. You shared a little bit about that as well during the ceremony.
Yeah, my wife, when she first came, when she first saw Danville, she's like, wow, you know, this reminds me of the Piedmont area of Italy.
Wow.
And for me to hear that from her and to see Danville from somebody else's eyes changed everything for me.
Absolutely.
And you can see today why that makes sense.
Well, can you tell me a little bit about why Danville? Why at this point? You talked a little bit about the Renaissance here in our community, and that probably had to play a factor in coming back.
Tremendous part of the factor, you know, with what's going on with the Institute and the city's commitment to kind of a rebirth of inner city and downtown.
Yeah.
There's a incredibly affordable housing in Danville. And as an investor, it's a very sound place for investment. The ROIs are very good for us.
Yeah. Well, let's talk a little bit about the initial investment you made here on North Main.
This is our first one.
Tell us a little bit about this.
Well, we purchased this from the Historical Society, and it was an ugly facade.
Mm-hmm.
And my friends here helped me see the vision of what it could be. It brought back to its life, you know, from the 1930s. It was actually built in 1894.
How about that?
And we worked with the Historical Society in Danville, as well as working to maintain historical tax credits so that we could help make it even more affordable.
Sure.
And what you see is a labor of love and some hard times along the way, frustrations to make it happen.
But a wonderful space. Now we've got the dance studio here.
Yes.
We just saw a demonstration from the owners
that
are making this space work for you. And it's just amazing the renovations that have been done just in a very short period of time. Right?
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
And then hopefully we'll be back here very soon with great news for the first floor.
Yeah.
And also I should apologize, I also own this building next door.
Yes.
Which that's next on our project list.
Great.
Our next step will be to clean up that facade and make that presentable again.
Wonderful.
Underneath that siding is actually a tin siding.
Oh, wow.
Which is very rare.
Unique.
And we
yes.
can't wait to bring that siding out.
That is
and
wonderful.
It's going to just... To have downtown Neapolis, as we like to call it, is going to be a real jewel for the city.
Yeah. You talk about Neapolis and how it was annexed into the city back in the 1800s,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, 1894. It was created as its own city.
Uh-huh.
And 2 years later, I guess city leaders of Danville saw the vision.
Yeah.
And they annexed it as
that?
Part of the city. Yeah,
that's very good. And it is coming a nice little arts district here.
It's
we've
beautiful.
Got the dance space. We've got the North Theater. We've got the new Thai restaurant
right.
that's opening. So
yeah.
I can just see this snowballing into
you
more and more
You can start to see what's in our head, what's next.
Yeah, that's great. Well, Steve, I really appreciate
Thank you
taking
very much.
The time to join us today.
Thank you
for your vision for this area, your investment, and we look forward to touching base with you in the future on more renovations.
Thank you very much.
All right,
it's a pleasure.
Well, joining me now is Jerry Meadows, and is a familiar face to many here in the community, and has really been overseeing this project for Steve as he makes his way back and forth from Nashville. But Jerry, I wanted to talk with you today just a little bit about the rebirth of the Arts District here in this North Main Hill area. Obviously, very close to your heart, the North Theater Project, but it's great to see the dance space opening up. Just wanted to get your thoughts on the arts in this area of Danville.
Well, I think, you know, what's interesting about Danville is that it has so many creative people. And often I think the community has ignored that through the years. So there is finally a focus and an emphasis on taking a look at the tremendous amount of gifted people that are born here or come here and develop here and giving them a new life. So it's
right.
being talked about in the River District. It's being talked about in the Tourist District and up here in what we hope to brand now is Neapolis, the new city in the Triangle here on North Main. So I'm excited that I had a part in reopening the North Theater and that it is still bringing programming to the public.
Right.
And I have really enjoyed being a part of Steve Del Giorno's investments in Danville and the renovations of this beautiful building from 1890 across the way here.
And just what a wonderful story Steve has from growing up, graduating from GW High School, going away for 20 years, you know, traveling the world, and then wanting to invest and deciding on Danville. That just speaks volumes really on what we're doing, because he heard about through you and other various avenues of what's happening here in the city, and it struck him that this was a place to invest.
I think that's thrilling, really. And I love today that his beautiful wife, Angela, who is from Korea and has traveled all over the world, when they were picking a place to invest in, she said, "This reminds me of the Italian Piedmont." Well, you know, here we are in the Virginia Piedmont.
That's great.
And we're standing here in November, and the sun's shining bright, and we're comfortable outside. So it's a grand environment, Danville. And as arts and culture grows, I think more and more people are going to be drawn here, and we'll discover what a wonderful life we have here.
Well, Jerry, I really appreciate you taking the time to join us today on River City TV to talk about this project and just the arts growing in our community. Thank you so much.
Great to see you always, Mark.